first on this one.
Oh, you're going to go first? Okay.
Okay, guys. Hold up. Do you see that?
That right there?
That looks like a label that's on the underneath can? This label? Are you kidding me?
Are you all recycling cans?
I think they are. What is that? You see that?
What is that?
Okay, that's...
All right.
You're losing points already. Now let me get into the design. All right, guys. I hope you got some lube because I'm about to rip you an asshole. A new
coming
one.
Around the corner, right there.
Yeah, I wonder who's is that Budweiser underneath there?
Is that a Bud Select?
Is that
can?
Miller?
Did y'all buy defective cans of Reebok?
Reebok stuck a label over the top of them.
You passed.
You
the
guys even brewery? Do you even brew this stuff?
Right.
All
right.
So the I'm Bavarian sorry. Flag. You got Fest beer, and you got two people cheering. Cool, trying to be different.
Hey, it could be two Yachty's.
You know what? If you're going to do two beers cheering, they better be Steins if it's Oktoberfest. So you
true,
guys.
True, true.
And it says Oktoberfest Golden Lager. It should say something along the lines, Marzen. I mean, you know, it would just fit with
the theme.
I
wonder if it does say Marzen somewhere on that can.
Maybe it says it on the label that they covered up on the original can. We're going to take that label off after the show and take a picture and post it, maybe. We might do it live. Because, we should do it live.
I think at the end of the show, we should pull it off and see.
See what it is?
What's under the can label?
Under the can. I'm giving you guys a one. I'm sorry.
Oh, damn.
You cover it up. Is that your original can? Is that recycled? If it's recycled, maybe it's on there. Let's see. Does it say?
He's giving you a one. With the fact that you might have rebranded another beer, I'm going to give you a one as well. So
Holy crap.
There's not a whole lot of originality to putting your, at least make the sticker that you're labeling
big enough
can,
to cover
enough
all the
to
other print.
Cover it all and where you can't see it through the white. You kind of like, you see an S or something. I don't know.
And we're going to find out afterwards.
I'm very interested on what we're really drinking.
Yeah. Is this really Burr Oak Fest beer? We're going to find out. And this is actually a 5.8. So
I'm kind of interested, Yachty.
They're getting ones.
We got one, so let's get into
the pour. Here we go.
Let's
bust
it
out.
There, boom.
This shit better have stars and glitter and sparkles and fireworks.
5.8.
Holy shit. It looks like a creamer went poured. Look at the head on that thing. You can't even see the beer. Where did the beer go?
It has to dissipate. Oh, it's coming back. It's like a race. And they're off to the races.
There it is. There it is.
It's coming to life now. It's coming to life, folks.
Slowly crawling up to the top.
Oh, man. To the top.
Straight to the top.
Yeah. The cream of the crop.
Mm. Oh, yeah, brother.
Oh, yeah.
Macho Man Randy Savage.
Oh, yeah. President Jack Tunney.
President. Okay, now this looks like the baby version of apple juice.
Baby apple juice light.
Yeah, this is the light version of apple juice.
And the head is just, it looked like some dirty windows.
I see one bubble that went up.
Yeah.
The head is shattering at the top now.
It's caving in. You see it coming together.
Is this just a poor investment opportunity just to, you know,
is
cover
this a
up?
Money grab? Is this truly a money grab?
You guys launder money. Did Ozarks inspire you?
Do you have money in the walls?
Yeah.
I want to come to your brewery and find out.
They got
out.
Money in the kegs.
Yeah, they do. Money in the kegs.
They're not their kegs, so yeah, if they get caught, it's someone else's problem, not theirs.
Yeah, they're pushing kegs and relabeling cans.
Yeah.
All right, Yachty, what do you give them on the pour?
Man,
I'm
going to
give
them
a two.
Two?
Yeah, I'm going to give them a two.
I agree. They're getting a two from me because
Yachty's giving them a two.
I didn't see no bubbles. I mean, the head was good, but it's dissipating pretty quickly.
It got my glass looking messed up, man.
Yeah.
I mean, yours, I mean, it's looking kind of homeless.
Yeah, the bubbles look like soapy water. So, I mean, the head looks like soapy water. It just
let's go ahead and get into the smell, Yachty.
Oh, shit.
Yachty.
You go ahead and tell them.
Have you done your damn laundry today?
Man, it smells like I didn't. Is that me or the beer?
Hold on.
This smells like a urinal and a dirty sock all in one. Just soaked
it up.
Did
you go hard last night and piss your jeans? And you put them in your hamper, and now you got the whole damn hamper smelling like piss?
Yeah, this is pissy jeans.
This is dirty hamper piss socks. Pissy jeans.
This is the piss socks.
Piss socks.
Oh, on smell?
Two? What are you going to give them?
I'm debating if it's one or two.
I almost wanted to give them one, but it kind of makes me wonder if...
I'm going to give them a two.
Since it's a 5.8, if it's going to actually taste all right. So I gave... You're going to match me?
I'm giving them a two.
Oh, he's matching.
Because if it's a one, it's got to be really bad.
He's matching, folks.
Yeah.
So let's get into the taste and the aftertaste, folks.
R.I.P. to us if this is bad.
Oh, hell no. See, what kind of Oktoberfest is this? Man, this tastes like some Keystone Light. Is that Keystone under the can?
It might be.
Man, what the?
There is nothing October about this fest right here. There is no fest, actually.
Is that Steel Reserve? Yeah, y'all got the diluted drippings of Keystone Light with a mix with a little bit of Steel Reserve.
I cannot pinpoint the taste on this. Like, man, a faint orange.
I'm not going to give them a bottom of a barrel because it's not horrible, but it's definitely not an Oktoberfest. I'm going to give them a two on that.
Man, I agree because... I've had some bad beers, and you guys aren't the worst.
This isn't dirt.
Yeah, this ain't dirt.
But you know what? Before we even refer to a friend or anything, peel that damn label off.
Let's take the label off this.
Man, peel that mother off. We got to peel the label off. I'm sorry. I'm sorry we're destroying your can.
Oh, and this is the best part. This is the best part.
We're really
good. This shit's actually coming off.
We're really good. Y'all should have used a better adhesive.
Oh, shit.
Does it have a whole new graphics? Do we get to review it all over again?
Oh, shit.
Oh, man.
What the fuck?
Is it Keystone?
No, look at this. I'm just going to put this on the carousel. Holy fuck.
Hold on.
The label is off. But, oh my God, Kansas Territory Brewing Company Horsepower Red Ale. What the fuck is this? Is this? Let's just let that rotate.
Oh man! They lied to me! Joe, where you at? This is a lawsuit. They lied to me.
Now I want to go get a Horsepower Red Ale.
Man,
keep it on there. Let the folks see it.
Hold on.
He's got to read it.
What the heck? Washington, Kansas. Okay, where is this? Where?
I am labeling my own fucking shit.
He's labeling his glass, folks.
My glass is now Fest Beer, too.
Oh, hold on.
But look, we need to look up Horsepower Red Ale, get some of their beer, and then get another one of these and see if it's the same. Are they just recycling cans? If they are, that'd be nice for them to say it on their label, their packaging.
Yachty, look up the website.
Horsepower Red Ale.
Do it live.
Here we go.
I'm sorry we have to do this to y'all. I mean, you got a Kansas City. This is what? Where are they from? Kansas City Territory Brewing Company.
Oh my God!
They're from Washington, Kansas. They're not even from Missouri, and this is, oh my God, they're lying to me. They said brewed and packaged by Brew Oak Brewing Company, LLC, Columbia, Missouri.
Wow.
Does it say anything on their website that they rebottle or offer white label or anything?
No. It says, a session beer meant to be enjoyed. Our red ale not only looks stunning, but tastes great too. The full malt body and subtle hop notes will keep you coming back to the red. And it's 5.9% alcohol. So, guess what, guys? This is the show Ozark at its finest in the brewing world. This is called laundering money. When you want to launder money and not dump the money into the actual process, you just stick a sticker on the beer and sell it. Say you sold a whole bunch of cases, and there you go. Welcome to the Dirty Cartel Gang. Yeah. Oh, here, that's here. The label it used to be. Now it's out of camera. No, that's good. That is crazy, guys.
So we thought we were drinking the Oktoberfest from Burr Oak. But we were actually drinking the Horsepower Red Ale. What a great addition to our first episode, Yachty. Wow.
We are the CSI. Hey,
Burr Oak Company is damn magicians. They're magicians.
So
let's see if we could have properly labeled this the right way.
I want to see if they're laundering money or not.
Is there a lawsuit out for them?
Maybe there is. I mean, they don't even have the percentage of alcohol on the label, by the way.
I mean, there's no way to even hide it, because even if you went up to hide the top, you'd still be...
The label's too short.
Man, oh man. I mean, now let hold on. They deserve Kansas City to... what is it?
What? I am looking at their website
the
right now.
What's the name of it? Kansas, my
Horsepower Red Ale.
No,
Kansas Territory Brewing Company.
Territory Brewing Company, right? So let's review the actual label that was on the can.
Yeah, we will be doing a comparison, guys.
So the Red Ale, the Horsepower, it's not a Oktoberfest, but they actually have graphics on an actual can. It's not a sticker. So I have more respect from Kansas City. What is it?
Kansas Territory.
Yeah, the Kansas Territory Horsepower Red L label than this bullshit. Like, what is this? What is this?
You guys, I hope they can redeem themselves, because this... doesn't even taste like an Oktoberfest.
It does not taste like an Oktoberfest, and you know why? Now we understand.
Horsepower Red Ale.
They picked a Red Ale. It's not even in the same category.
Yeah.
Man, I'm calling Joe.
Call Joe. He's our attorney. And I'm looking at Burr Oak's website.
Hold on. I paid a whole... Let me put my price tag back on.
What'd you pay?
I paid a whole $1.99 for... I paid $1.99 at Randall's today to get lied to.
You got straight up lied.
I got lied to. Let's put this off to the side.
Look at this shit.
That's off to the side. I mean, it's not horrible. The Red Ale is not horrible. Now that I know that it's not Oktoberfest, the Red Ale is not horrible.
I want to talk to them and see if this is actually just, it is private labeled, and they just have a horrible beer or
so,
not.
Now, let's think about this for a second. Would you refer the Burr Oak Oktoberfest if you were under the assumption that it was Oktoberfest?
No, it's still nasty. It's still nasty. But no.
If we were reviewing Red Ales, not Oktoberfest, would you refer it to a friend?
No.
Neither. It's a lose-lose
for you guys.
Lose-lose.
I mean, shit. You should at least package it on fucking Polliner or something if you're going to go hard like that.
Maybe we should go and change the name.
What did we give them on taste? What are we giving them on taste?
We gave them a two.
Two? Giving them a two.
We gave them a two.
By the way, folks, I'm keeping track of all of our ratings, and then we actually, at the end, I got a spreadsheet I built. Kind of smart sometimes.
Yep.
And that will tell us who wins out of all of our ratings right here.
Yes, and if you want to follow the rating structure and you know, base your judgment on a beer to try or to bring to a party or if you're having an event or something and you kind of need that review before you go and buy, make sure to follow the Facebook and check out the review Excel spreadsheet that Mark will have.
Yeah, we'll post it.
You have like a nice graphic or whatever that we're going to be posting.
Yep.
So you guys will be able to check out the ratings and base your judgment on
buying. At the end of the show, you'll see
it. Yeah, you'll see it.